Hello, in today's video, we're going to be updating our event handler and our file loader function that we created around 6 months ago. But even if you've not watched that video, you can still watch this video to update your own existing handler, so it's a win-win. If you have been following this series, then you should have your event handler file looking like this and your load files function like this. Go ahead and delete everything in them and let's start over and dive in. First, we'll require the globe package. If you don't have it installed, type npm I globe in your console. If you do, make sure to update it to the latest version by typing npm update instead. Now we require the path package, which is a native JS package that you don't need to install. Here we'll create a delete cached file function that takes in a file path as an argument. Now we resolve the file path to get an absolute path and we check if the file is cached. Then we'll delete the cached version of it. Here we'll create the load files function that takes a directory name as its argument. Then we use the globe model to find all JavaScript files in the specified directory and its subdirectories. Now we filter out any known JavaScript files, again as globe can sometimes bug out and grab different files, so this is solely a safety measure. Now we use the promise.all to asynchronously delete the cached version of all JavaScript files found in the previous step using the delete cached file function that we created earlier. Here we'll return the array of the JavaScript files and catch any errors thrown during the execution of the load files function and log them to the console. And now we export the load files function so we can use it in other files or functions. Now we'll head over to our event handler file and require the load files function that we just updated or created earlier. Then we're going to create a load events function that takes in the client object as an argument. Then we're going to console.timethis file to be able to calculate the time this function takes to do its job, which is a nice statistic to see. Now we replace the client.events collection with a completely new map, which is the better way of doing it than we did before with the .clear method. Now make sure this collection is created in your index.js file, which you should have if you've been following along this series. Then we create an empty array of events that we will later utilize to log loaded events to our console table. Now we use the load files function to load the event files from their directory, and then we loop through the map of files, and inside a try and a catch block we require each event to our cache. Here we create a wrapper function that accepts any number of arguments and calls the event.execute function with those arguments while allowing the client object to be used. Now we set the target variable to either use the WebSocket or REST API interface depending on which interface is required by the event being handled. Now based on whether the event should be listened to only once or multiple times, it checks if the event.once property is set to true. If not, it will default to the own method, which is the most used method. Then we create an entry inside the client.events collection for every event we load, marking the key as the name of the event and its execute function as its value so we can call on the execute function whenever we detect the event. Then we push the successfully loaded events to our events array, marking them with the green icon. And if an error occurs, we'll just push the event causing the error to the array with the red icon. Now we create a console table with the event and status as tab list. Then we console.info that we loaded the events in a light blue color, which is this random characters that you see. Don't worry, I'm going to place this line in the description because I know it will give you a headache trying to type it out on your own. Then we're going to end the timer and print it to the console. Lastly, we'll export the load events function because we use it in our index.js file and also in our reload event command file as well. Now if we restart the bot, we can see the new look of the loaded events list with the time that it took to load them. And this is our command handler table for comparisons. Thank you guys for watching, and if you want me to update our command handler as well, make sure to let me know in the comments. Thank you and goodbye.